every way. Here we go.
I'm mad about the boy.
Coming up now toward the national speed limit.
And
some of the shape has been lost, some of the style.
I'm mad about the boy.
But like talking to you. So
I love people's faces in traffic jams. Or was it so miserable? Could be worse. You could be shot in the back of the head by a marksman.
That's all we've got time for. Let's just find out. What do you drive, sir?
355.
A Ferrari.
Yeah.
There's an interesting statistic on Ferrari. What is it, James?
90% of people who said they had a Ferrari were lying.
It's true. People were actually filling in the form, and then we checked everything, or the company that did it, checked everything with the DVLA. 90% hadn't got a Ferrari. And you think, why did you do that? What did you think some really beautiful girl was going to... Ooh, there's a bloke of cars in the last few weeks. We haven't put them up. We're going to start with the Bentley Continental GT. Where do we think? Thank you all for your opinion. It's cool.
It is cool.
However, with a proviso, as soon as you open your copy of the Sun newspaper and you see that Mr. Beckham has taken delivery of his, it's on its way down. But for now, since he doesn't have one, it's a cool...
It's stupid.
This is my favourite, though. It's a sort of radar parking device.
Normally, I look for really easy parking spaces, but in the BMW, I look for the tricky ones, just for the fun of it.
Hey, I mean, look, we've got an MG here, and this is an Alpha Spider.
And then there's a great big fat old
twin turbocharged.
Giant wobbly car for putting Americans in.
Twin turbocharged versus the one designed
3.5 litre
by a man from Leicester.
Okay.
Okay, well, here we go, he said rather nervously.
Good luck.
It's got a bad start. But turbocharged. Come on! And so, on that crushing blow for Richard Atomic Kitten Hamster...
Says Mr. Jeremy Jethro Tull Clarkson.
..has a ring. Tell you what, though, you know in the olden days when people actually had Capris? They always had the bonnet up on a Saturday tinkering around with the engine.
Fettling.
Exactly. Well, nowadays, people always fiddle around with computers.
Yeah.
So what this has got, which is amazing... Well, if they ever get around to putting a bonnet in it, which they haven't at the moment, it'll have a...
Plug, port
thing. You put your laptop in it and you'll be able to adjust like the rev limiter and the suspension settings and everything.
But it goes further than that. It's very clever because once you've got your laptop plugged in, you can then log on to the internet and you can actually download specifications and settings direct from Ford. And better than that even, you can then exchange data with your mates and their VSOS.
So if you got one, I could set the rev limit at like 1500 RPM. Have the headlamps flash every time we went above 10.
Not quite what they meant there, really.
Or even better, if you get stuck behind one on the road, what you could do is dial up its computer from your laptop, Bluetooth, mobile phone, speed him up a bit. 150.
Right.
And that's... then just apply one of the rear brakes.
Yeah, that's just stupid.
Anything. But I'm afraid I have some bad news. The Stig is dead. And so we've prepared this little tribute to the easy listening man in black. Looking fast. Oh, that is very fast. Good Stig. Oh, nearly tail slide. He's still kept the power on. Stoke up the stick. It's up to a huge speed.
Seasons don't feel the reaper, nor do the wind, the sun, or the rain.
And he crosses the line in!
My car.
Come on, baby, don't feel the reaper. Baby, take my hand, don't feel the reaper. We'll be able to...
going to kill himself. We're going to need a new stick. 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 Sad day. But there's plenty more where he came from. So, ladies and gentlemen, a very big hand, please, for Top Gear's new Steg! One, the dead one, this one will be letting his driving do the talking. And he'll be doing just that, actually. To spare.
This Rover 75 might look as if it came out of the 1950s, but in many ways it's the right car for modern Britain. Now, I'm a big fan of modern Britain, but let's think about what it means to the motorists. It's sleeping policemen, gatzos, congestion, broken up road surfaces, all that sort of stuff. Stress. Now, when you're faced with that, what do you want? 0 to 60 in 5, 4, 3 seconds? Louvres on your bonnet? I don't think so. You want peace. That's what the Rover gives you, peace.
There's nothing raucous about its V6 engine. It rides more smoothly than a Rolls-Royce Corniche, and it's trimmed like a first-class cabin on the Titanic, before it sank.
Now, when Jeremy drives a car, he drives a car like this. In fact, even when he's just talking about a car, he does this. And Hammond talks about barreling along in his Morgan. I don't want a barrel. I want a waft.
OK, the Rover is a proper symbol of British defiance.
Awful
The places. Reason why Britain has no car industry anymore, why all the names are gone, is because we live in the past. We used to be a great country.
Now, look...
Noble has come along and said, we are now in the 21st century, let's build a car to beat the world.
No, I could build your car. I couldn't build a Morgan.
You could carve a chisel.
It's craftsman built, not some spotty teenager with a rivet gun.
Now, the problem with the Morgan is it's just a car that they forgot to stop making in the 40s.
No, that's entirely wrong.
OK, the problem with the Noble is the engine's in the wrong place.
You will admit this is a beautiful car.
No.
It's all right.
I wouldn't admit that.
It's a toy. It's not a car.
Of course, it isn't especially comfortable or quiet, and you can't put heavy shopping in the boot in case it falls through the cardboard floor. And you can't use it unless it's hot and sunny. And if it is hot and sunny, you'll melt because there's no air conditioning. And if rain is on the way, you won't know because you can't hear the weather forecast because there's no radio.
Elaborate. Odd one here from Steve Rowland. We have a cat called Stig. So can you please change the name of your racing driver to something other than Stig? Because every time your program on his sleep is disturbed when you mention the Stig's name. Actually, come to think of it, Stig. See those slippers? Pee in them.
Now, you may remember, last week, we discovered that if you hold your car's remote control central locking device against your head, it doubles its range.
okay? Mm. Now, we didn't understand that.
No.
There was a girl in the audience last week who was a scientist, and she said it had to do with the fillings in your teeth.
Yeah, but we tested that.
We did. Our producer deigned to come into work one day, and
nice.
He has no fillings in his teeth, and it worked for him, so it isn't that. Mm. Loads of people have written to us, and all we've been able to discover is that no scientists watch Top Gear.
No, that much is clear.
Not one. There's a chap here who says the reason is it's because your body acts like a grounding plane, which sounds good, it sounds a sort of plausible explanation, but then you read on and he's got a GSXR 1000, which I believe...
That was brilliant!
Yeah. He's a biker, sound fellow, I believe him. Lots of people think it is your body that does it. Guy here, Craig from Bromley, reckons it's because your body has iron in it.
Well...
Yeah, but it does, but a tiny bit.
I have no iron in my body. I am pure fat.
All the way through.
Yeah, I am just fat from here down. Well, fat and hair.
What I say is it's nice to be consistent.
I am, yeah. There's a chap here called Zinkan at America Online, and he says it's human bones are a great amplifier of radio waves, and it's something to do with your elbows.
No, we had loads that were to do with bits of your body doing this. So we had one guy who reckons it's your ears working as radar, which I quite like. Another one, not sure about this, saying it's your nasal cavities. Apparently they're as big as an acoustic guitar or something, which... They're not, are they?
Close, but
well,
it's
I'm
not.
I'm looking at you and I'm thinking it's quite a big schnozzer, but it's nowhere near an acoustic guitar.
That ain't no guitar. No.
You know, I'm not going to see you come up. That bloke's got a guitar on his face.
For a nose.
It's rubbish.
No, you're not. I know, there's some bizarre
stuff. I mean, what they're basically saying, I think what the audience is saying here is that if you were to build a creature that had my bone structure with sort of enormous elbows and Martin Clunes's ears...
Looking good.
..and Daniela Westbrook's nose...
Nice touch.
..you could set off some nuclear missiles in North Korea from your house.
...your car.
The plane takes off at 137 miles an hour. The car doesn't. The plane is made by Saab. The car is made by General Motors. And finally, the plane uses a Volvo engine.
And they're off. 2.3 litre, 250 horsepower turbo against 21,500 pounds of jet thrust. Harry is off the ground and already doing 200 miles an hour. Saab's up to 58. Easy.
Hi, Jeremy. With an exclamation mark. It's very irritating. But this is from Claire, and she signed it with a little X, which is like a little kiss. My boyfriend has just bought a new Audi A3. Fair enough. Now he's driving me mad with this new game he has where he tries to plip the remote locking from as far away as possible. Is he normal? Yes, clearly. In fact, I'd say, if anything, he sounds like a bit of an amateur.
Yeah, because it's how you do the plip
in
that
fact,
matters.
Claire, I'm going to... This is for your fella. I'm going to show some moves here.
Yeah.
I've got some special ones. This first one is called the bond, and it's perhaps more of a closing manoeuvre. So the car's there, and you walk away from your car, thus, and then at the last minute, you turn and fire. It's a simple, good one to start with, I reckon.
Keeping the range good.
Yeah.
I quite like the high shot. If you could demonstrate it's, that.
The true high shot is that.
That's the high shot, which we like very much. Then there's a really good one, which is the I've lost my car in the multi-story.
That's also known as the lawn sprinkler. Like that.
Waiting for the things to cover. All this stuff is being spoiled by these things. This is keyless entry, OK? Now, they tell us that when you walk up to the car, if you've got one of these in your pocket, the door is open, OK? So I was walking up to the car, opening the door, thinking, that's fine, you get out, lock it, and you assume, if you walk away, it'll lock itself.
It does, doesn't it?
Well, this is it. You've got a 100-gram Merc, and you think, is that locked? So you go back, and it's open, and you think, well, it would be.
To me,
so you have to say to passers-by, sorry, could you just hold that? Then you go back, and then you find out it doesn't lock itself.
Yeah.
You have to push a button. How uncool is that?
That's very poor. I must say that I think they're going the wrong way with these sort of pairing
them back, actually.
With these key cards, pairing them down to nothing. I think if they really want to know their market and appeal to, let's be honest, us chaps, they should go the other way and make them more...
...anymore. I mean, who's going around the M25 and thinks, I've suddenly decided I need a pair of trousers? Oh, for God's sake. My video's in the discount bin. £3.99.
Let's go! But for an Italian car, there's still something that bothers me.
Thank you.
Well, that's not right. I mean, I've had this thing nearly a week and nothing's fallen off and everything still works. I mean, who the hell do the Italians think they are anyway? The Germans?
Having been given it, I'm delighted I'm not going to be able to accept it personally, because this is, without question, the most pathetic award I've ever seen in my life.
There was the GT70, which I bought. Here it is, look, doors open and everything. Fantastic. Because anybody whose eyes were working properly would recognise that this is the ugliest thing. It is!
It is a superb-looking car.
It's the first car ever where children will be sick before they get in the back.
Rubbish.
We'll have a vote. All right. Hands up, everyone who thinks it's ugly. I didn't prompt them or anything. Now hands up those who think it's not ugly. You see, all the ones who've left their glasses at home.
All right, all right. You are an executive. This is going to take a bit of imagination. You're an executive, OK, and you're going to buy a new car. You're not going to buy that S-Type Jag, are you? It's a great drive, but you wouldn't let your kids sit around with their mouths open like that.
No.
E-Class Mercedes. Now, you've got a Mercedes. How much have you enjoyed it over the summer?
No, I haven't. It's been in the shop the entire time. It goes in, it's broken, it comes back more broken and goes in again. That's pretty much Mercedes ownership.
So you're not having one of those?
No.
You're not having an Audi A6 because it's too old?
No.
You're not having a Kia Magentis because it's stupid? No, you wouldn't.
No, you're right, I wouldn't.
And you're not going to have an Alpha 166 because nobody would buy a new one?
Yeah.
You, Jeremy Clarkson, you are the European Director of Photocopying, Brackets, Toner, Distribution. You will buy one of these.
I've suddenly decided I don't want to talk to you anymore.
20,000 tons of aircraft carrier and home to a fleet of Harrier jump jets. This plane goes from 0 to 60 in 2.8 seconds and is hitting 100 miles an hour by the time it reaches the end of the 200-metre runway. And that has given the Stig his biggest challenge yet, 100 miles an hour in 200 metres. Obviously, he needed a special kind of vehicle. And this is it. The old Top Gear Jag. Bought for a couple of hundred quid, it was stripped of its fat and fitted with nitrous injection. That meant 500 brake horsepower. In a drag race in the last series, it beat just about every supercar on the planet. But is it enough here? Top Gun versus Top Gear. 100 miles an hour in 200 meters, and unlike the pilot, the Stig must leave himself enough space to pull up again.
And he's off, there we go. Now he's got to get to 100 and then stop again. Here we go. That's too fast. That was not supposed to happen. And that is unquestionably the end of our Jaguar. But what about the Stig? That is all that was there. The Navy divers went down, but they couldn't find...
3, 2, 1, go!
Yes! 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 Loser!
Said in the book!
Don't believe the Germans!
Who cares how fast your roof is, anyway?
You cared! You cared! You of all! I've got the fastest automatic electric roof in the world, and now it's a... I think. You know when a dog's doing its number twos? that kind of arched back thing. That's what it is. Hideous. No one knows what torque is, but this has 144 of them.
A small hatchback, OK? When you drive one of those and it's a diesel, it says three things about you. One is you're tighter than two coats of paint. The second one is that you care so much about the environment that you want to leave a little protective sooty film over it. And the third one is you're probably French.
I've suddenly remembered why I don't...
Back to Lamborghini, and believe it or not, this is one. It's an LM002 from the 1980s. It's a sort of military Jeep thing, but it has the V12 engine from the Countach. Now, these days, you could get one of these for about £35,000, which sounds like a bargain, and it does look like fun. However, we would urge caution.
Absolutely. When I started in this business writing about cars, I was earning about 40 quid a week. OK, I borrowed one of these, took it into a petrol station to fill it up, £147. and you had to reset the pump halfway through. So you go, pump stopped you to go in and pay, then come out and recommence the filling process. And actually, it's no better today. In fact, it's worse, because the tyres are... How much are they?
£550 each.
Each?
Yep.
Each... And if you were to fill this up now, 63, 64 gallon tank, £220 in petrol. Look at that for a face. Record.
I love people's faces in traffic jams. Oh, is it so miserable? Could be worse. You could be shot in the back of the head by a marksman.
That you haven't.
Odd one here from Steve Rowland. We have a cat called Stig, so can you please change the name of your racing driver to something other than Stig, because every time your program on, his sleep is disturbed when you mention the Stig's name. Actually, come to think of it, Stig. See those slippers? Pee in them.
Go. Oh, the Honda the S2000, Honda. 137 to beat.
Yes!
That's all we've got time for.
Long way away, hold on a second. Dear Jeremy, my aim is to meet you in your...
Read out what it actually says. Dear?
Dear superstar Mr. Jeremy Clarkson.
And just do the end as well.
Best luck to you, King.
That'd be me.
What on earth is the man going on about? It is rather difficult to understand. My aim is to meet you, and I send with this post a VCD. It is show how I and my friends driving. It's contained. It does get a little bit difficult to follow, but the video that they sent in is very easy to follow.
This is a Toyota Carina, front-wheel drive.
It is.
So he must be using the handbrake to make it do this into the oil tank. And now he just misses that. Well done.
That's just madness! He's in the street, there are people there. This man is insane!
Obviously, you shouldn't listen to those people who say, oh, we can't tell it's a diesel under the bonnet. Sounds just like a petrol, because it doesn't. Sounds like it's been fueled with sandpaper. But, crucially, it's not so noisy that I can't hear Ken Bruce's Potmaster.
Titles of three UK single chart hits. Four. Squeeze. Three.
Call for Cats, labelled with love, up the junction. Come on, useless man.
So.
And then from here back, it looks like they haven't bothered. Honestly, I have seen more attractive gangrenous wounds than this. It is a monkfish among cars. It has the sex appeal of a camel with gingivitis. And frankly, I would rather walk back to the studio than drive another yard in it. So I shall. That way. I want to just do this award, if I may. It's the Enemy of the State Award, the person who's done the most to harm the cause of the petrol head these last 12 months. Gentlemen, the nominations.
The Chief Constable of North Wales, Richard Brunstrom, for his resolutely unpopular anti-motorist stance.
There are no more nominations.
So, the winner is the Chief Constable of North Wales.
This is the man who described speeding motorists as criminals.
And then regretted it shortly afterwards when one national newspaper allegedly caught his daughter speeding.
Actually, this is also the man who said there is no more excuse for drifting over the speed limit than there is for drifting a knife into someone. which really isn't true, is it?
It's interesting to note that in April of this year, as his war on the motorists carried on, his force posted the lowest clear-up rate for burglaries ever on record.
Right, we've thought of some rules about this. To qualify as a future classic, any car, we're talking about stuff from the 90s, has to be one of these things. Rare,
yes.
Beautiful,
yes.
Or interesting. And yes. I'd like to propose the original Lexus LS400.
Which is none of those things.
I think it's interesting.
No, it's not interesting, it's not rare, and it sure as heck isn't beautiful. It's hideous, James.
What's wrong with it?
Well, we've had this wall 5 minutes,
right.
And we just ruined it.
I'll put it there, but I'll tell you a story, OK? When I was at school, 1979, I was a schoolboy. At the end of the school day, we used to run down the end of the drive and line up because we wanted to laugh at my English teacher as she drove home in the Mark II Jag.
Yes, but that can go. I mean, that
see,
became beautiful.
Know.
That
just
never will.
There.
It belongs
here.
Well, I've got one here, okay? The Citroën XM.
Oh,
bear with me. It is red.
I'm sorry.
That no. goes there, and we'll explain
He's
why
right.
in a minute.
Would anyone
right.
like to hazard a guess why the Citroën XM was rare?
Now, look. Jeremy, can I ask, what's that?
This is an Alfa Romeo GTV 6, a magnificent car.
I believe you had one.
I did indeed.
And how much did you pay for it, Jeremy?
£5,000.
Mm, and then you sold it, and how much did you sell it for?
£3,000.
OK, that didn't go too well. How much was it worth a year later?
£7,000.
So how much do you know about all of this? Absolutely nothing.
Made a mistake on this one.
Well, on yeah. that subject, could I bring up the original BMW CSL? I believe you had one of these as well, didn't
I
you?
I did.
And how much did you pay for it?
£3,000.
And how much did you sell it for?
£2,000.
And how much was it worth about a year later?
£12,000.
In fact, as well, BMW Z1, that's a car you had and you sold it, made a loss. They're going up in value. It is, in fact, classic.
The Ferrari F355. Did you have one of these?
Yes,
have
yes,
you sold
yes,
it?
Yes.
Yes, future classic.
can I just interrupt here? Get out of the way. All of these cars, you'll note, I've chosen well.
Oh, yes.
All of them are classics.
Oh, very well, Jeremy.
It's my timing.
The timing is everything. It's like the stock market. What you're doing is buying high and selling low.
I've just come up with another rule of future classics. Jeremy buys, you sell. He's
yes.
selling, you buy. OK, there you go.
I love the way that these people come along and comment on style. That's
Good
terrific.
Lord.
It's great, isn't it? In kind of a...
All right. You are an executive. This is going to take a bit of imagination. You're an executive, OK, and you're going to buy a new car. You're not going to buy that S-Type Jag, are you? It's
no.
a great drive, but you wouldn't let your kids sit around with their mouths open like that.
No.
E-Class Mercedes. Now, you've got a Mercedes. How much have you enjoyed it over the summer?
No, I haven't. It's been in the shop the entire time. It goes in, it's broken, it comes back more broken and goes in again. That's
right.
pretty much Mercedes ownership.
So you're
days.
Not having one of those?
No.
You're not having an Audi A6 because it's too old?
No.
You're not having a Kia Magentis because it's
I might.
Stupid? No, you wouldn't.
No, you're right, I wouldn't.
And you're not going to have an Alfa 166 because nobody would buy a new one?
Yeah.
You, Jeremy Clarkson, you are the European Director of Photocopying, brackets, toner, distribution. You will buy one of these.
I've suddenly decided I don't want to talk to you anymore.